Chapter 12, Bunking Off. Bunking off school was not something Jack had ever done before. However, he knew he had to make sure Grandpa got all the way home. The old man was much more confused than usual. Miss Verity had completely taken the wind from beneath his wings, and now Grandpa was looking a little wobbly. And the last thing the boy wanted to do was call his parents. If they found out how disastrously Grandpa's visit to the school had gone, chances were they would want to send him straight back to Twilight Towers. So Jack led them back to Grandpa's flat. When the pair approached, Raj was in a grimy window of his shop. The newsagent was busy showing off his artistic side. He was arranging a rather surreal display of his two main special offers of the week, licorice and football cards. The licorice was wrapped around the cart, making both look highly undesirable. As soon as he spotted Jack and his grandfather, Raj rushed out of his shop to meet them. "Ah, Mr. Bunting, Master Bunting. It's Bunting," corrected Jack. "That's what I said," protested Raj. "Bunting." Like all the local children, Jack liked the newsagent very much. The man never failed to put a smile on your face. "So, Mr. Bunting, how is my favourite customer today? I was worried sick when you went missing from your flat in the middle of the night." "Ah, Charwalla, there you are," proclaimed Grandpa. "Charwalla? What on earth does that mean?" asked Jack. He had never heard such a phrase before. Raj whispered to the boy, "I asked my father back in India. He told me it's the name for an Indian man who serves tea. They sometimes did to British soldiers during World War II. I think your grandfather is getting more confused by the day." "What's that, Charwalla?" barked Grandpa as he started helping himself to some out-of-date chocolate bars. "Nothing, sir," replied Raj. "I found it much easier to just go along with him," he added in a whisper to Jack. "Me too," replied the boy. "Now, I am going to need some help getting him settled upstairs." "Of course, young man. Before we go, might I be able to interest you in a copy of the Radio Times from 1975? "No, thank you, Raj." The newsagent was not giving up. "Many of the shows on TV now are just repeats, so it might still be accurate." "We really should be getting him upstairs." "Of course. Now, what would you give me for this chocolate-covered toffee? Someone has licked off the chocolate and the toffee centre is missing." With that, the newsagent took out a shiny piece of purple paper from his pocket. "Raj, that's just the wrapper. That's why it's half price. There's no sweet. You can sniff the wrapper." "Enough chitter-chatter, thank you, Charwalla," interrupted Grandad as he stuffed a few out-of-date chocolate bars into his pocket for later. "It's time for my afternoon nap." It felt strange putting an old man to bed. Until recently, it would have been Grandpa tucking Jack in. Now the roles had been reversed. Of late, Grandpa would become tired during the day, so he took an hour's nap every day after lunch. Raj had locked up his shop for a short while so that he could help Jack get his grandfather safely up the stairs. 40 winks, that's what Grandpa always called his nap time. Raj drew the frayed curtains in the bedroom as Jack arranged the old man's blanket. "Make sure my Spitfire is full of fuel, will you, squadron leader? I need to be at the ready in case we are scrambled. The Luftwaffe could be back at any moment." "Yes, of course, Grandpa," replied Jack without thinking. "Who's this Grandpa?" he demanded, suddenly looking wide awake. "I mean, yes, of course, Wing Commander, sir." Jack added a salute to complete the illusion. "That's better, officer. Dismissed." "I'm plumb tuckered out." And with that, the boy's grandfather saluted and stifled a yawn. As soon as he had closed his eyes, the deafening snoring began. Up and down went the ends of the old man's moustache as Jack and Raj tiptoed out of his bedroom. There we go.